To most diasporans, they would consider union to be a myth, an unbelievable one even on worlds visited by an union administrator, as most won't even live long enough to see one. But the albatross? The albatross are legends. In the vast galaxy, a distress call is a message written with desperation, and often, even if someone does listen to it, nobody could respond to it in time. But that clearly didn't stop Albatross from listening to the call for thousands of years in the past, and the next thousand years in the future. Transiting from near light to real space, supported by light capital ships, subline vessels, and fighter wings, the loyal wings of the Albatross would launch practically immediately from their carrier for one goal, to answer the call for help. They do not fight protracted campaigns, they do not conduct long-term rebuilding of a world, the Albatross listens, responds to the biggest problem in the system, and quickly moves on to other worlds in need. Those were instead, the Union's role to fill. Officially recognized by Union as an autonomous nomadic state, the Albatross is an independent organization with no land to speak of. As such, in modern age, the Albatross is supplied by interplanetary shipping Northstar for weapons, ships, and of course, chassis. If anything, one could say the Albatross has firm diplomatic ties with IPS Northstar, which also maintains cosmopolitan embassies for retired members of the Albatross. As cosmopolitans, the Albatross appears ageless to the diasporans they have served for thousands of years. It's no doubt that for all the diasporan worlds they have saved, there are just as many myths and histories about them on those worlds, often depicting them as mythic demigod living in their own separated plane of time until they are needed. That doesn't mean the Albatross are without enemies, however. Their noble deed run counter against other organization like the various Karaik and Baronic houses and free companies, independent and possibly less ethical mercenary groups, and Harrison Armory legions that tries to muscle their way in for many, many, diasporan worlds. In terms of organizations, each detachment of loyal wings and their support personnel is organized around a Maktaba, a monastic moon or station that essentially acts as their home base between century-long patrol, real-time. Each detachment would field around 100 to 200 chassis, split between 4 to 5 light to mid-weight vessels. Usually, there's only one detachment per Maktaba, but larger one could contain 2 or 3 detachments of loyal wings. With emphasis on speed, an average Albatross force is specialized in rapid engagement in zero-gravity ships or stations, and in limited orbital-to-ground surgical strikes, which certainly gives quite an image when the Albatross came straight down from the sky like angels from heaven. Due to the Albatross status as a cosmopolitan organization, they usually recruit mech pilots from within, young Maktaban youths trained through apprenticeship, but sometimes, rarely, an outsider could join in, after vowing to shed their past life and any connections they had, as they often will never see their family ever again, such is the life of a Maktaban. During the course of their training, the Albatross cadets of all origins would bear the rank of young petrel, or petrel, interchangeable either way, and only after years of training, deployments, and self-reflection, working as squires and apprentices under a loyal wing, the rank and title of an Albatross mech pilot, will they get nomination to become a loyal wing, the process of which will take another couple years and deployments until they are approved by a council of loyal wings in the detachment. Once a loyal wing, Albatross pilots are expected to begin the training of their own group of petrels as well as protecting them in deployment, and work in unison with other loyal wings as active senior members of their Maktaba. There are ranks above a loyal wing, of course, but Albatross hierarchy at this level is largely horizontal and honestly kinda informal, more based on connections, deeds, and such. After reaching this point, Albatross pilots usually serve for life in their detachment, either until unfortunate but hopefully heroic death, or retirement to their Maktaba to teach, cook, tend to the next generation or the garden and so on. At this stage of their life, Albatross pilots aren't forbidden to leave the Maktaba and return to their home worlds, but few do, preferring to serve in the Albatross until their final death. The Albatross, to simply put, are relativistic knights, Ronins, and gunslingers rendered immortal by the laws of reality and in the tales of diasporans saved by them. There might not be enough of them for this vast galaxy, they might fail in their task to save those in need, but one day, when a world cries for help, someone will always answer the call. Hello there, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and click that notification bell button. If you really want to support my channel, you could visit my Patreon page, or buy me some Ko-fi, links in the description. Anyway, have a nice day.